You are about to listen to a shortened preview episode of the Life Power Journeys podcast with Coach Lewis.
Because now her reason, her why is strong enough. Fuck this. If he tells me to jump off the roof, I'm going to jump off the roof. I got to lose weight. How in the hell did I gain 17 pounds? I'm eating good. So that's what I'm trying to explain to you. That's most people's journey. Man, I'm exercising so hard. Okay, well, this didn't work. Well, hey, he's trying this. Let me go over there. So you're jumping from fad to fad to fad, and you're sweating, and you're getting tired, and you're making sacrifices. Most of the people that I meet are genuinely trying to, like, it's not like they don't necessarily think that they're half-assing it, but they don't know the process, but they're trying, right? You got that little hamster on the wheel, and his ass is going crazy, trying to spin. Where's he going?
Nowhere.
Just like everybody else. I went to CrossFit. I did this, all these classes, all these Zumba, all this, whatever. It's one fad to the next. And the reason why is because they're not getting to the root problem. The root problem is between your ears, and it's in your heart. It's beating in your chest. You turn 40. Why do you want to get in shape? Let me just ask you.
The number one reason is just to be healthy.
Well, what is that?
I want to be able to move easy. Sorry, I have a really bad cold.
Why? Why do you want to move easy? Why?
I get enjoyment from being able to move easy. I get enjoyment from playing sports. I get enjoyment from... not being sore if I get up out of a chair or walk out of a car.
And so what caused you at some point? So you say you enjoy that.
Yeah.
So now you're looking for it. That means you lost it somewhere. So why? Why'd you lose it? What happened?
Complacency. Comfort. There's comfort in laziness. There's just comfort in sitting. I have a desk job. I have a long commute for work. And there's just comfort
in
sitting.
Life got in the way. Let's call it what it is. Life got in the way.
Well, chairs are just comfortable.
You became an adult.
Yeah.
Got to get a job.
Yeah.
I can't just go to the beach, hang out at the gym. I got to sit in my car. You got to drive an hour to go. What is it, an hour and a half to your
job? About an hour and a half.
Yeah. So 3 hours each way travel, commute. Then you get to the job and you're sitting down. So you like to move easy. You got comfortable. You have a desk job. You have every reason to fail. So my point is that you lost your purpose in exercise. What became more important than exercise? Money, right? You need more money. You need money better, more than you need muscles. You got to pay the bills. You got to keep a roof over your head. So life got in your way. And we're just talking about you, but how many other people? I got kids. Hey, I got to take my kids here. I got to pick them up from school. They're in sports. Hey, my husband this. Hey, my wife that. Something's always getting in the way, and your health and fitness takes a back seat. Because too many people label health and this is how I get to know who you are. I don't want to give you the answers, but what is health and fitness? You just said, I want to be healthy. Well, what does that mean? What's health and fitness? What's your definition of health and fitness?
My definition of a health and fit lifestyle is eating what's nutritionally good for you in order for my body and brain to work optimally. And fitness is just to move throughout the day. I don't know how to answer the second half of that question, but
a better answer than most people have. Most people stumble. It's eating this, it's eating healthy food, it's exercising, and that's part of why people fail, because they overcomplicate the simple. Health and fitness is nothing more than, and we could talk about mental fitness, emotional fitness. Does my body work for me or against me? It's that simple. The if you look up the dictionary, it talks about if you look up health, it's going to be the absence of disease or illness. Okay, that's a great place to start, but that doesn't mean I'm fit. My question to you is I'm not going to ask you what you weigh. Hey, what's your BMI? What's your body fat percentage?
I'm not secretive.
How much? No, I don't care. I really don't care. For me, it's irrelevant.
Yeah.
There is no right answer, because you're an individual. So your answer only matters to you.
Right.
My question is can you run away from a dog that's chasing you?
Yes.
You're laughing, right? Because you're like, I don't know, I thought about that, but that's health and fitness. Is my body working for me or against me? Can I run away from that animal that's trying to bite me and harm me? That's one angle of it. You live alone, you're married, kids, wife?
I live with my mother.
Okay. How old is she?
68.
Okay. Give or take. How much does she weigh? I'm sorry, Mom, if I offend you here, but
130, maybe.
Okay,
140.
130.
She's in pretty good shape.
Okay. 130. Let's just, even 100 pounds. Have you ever picked up a loose sandbag weighing 100 pounds?
Yes.
100 pounds is like, it becomes like, holy shit, this is fucking heavy.
Yeah.
All right. So my question is this. You come home. Mom had a stroke. Mom, you don't know. You're coming home thinking every day is normal. You walk in. You live alone with her. You haven't been home. She's been home all day. Mom, where are you? Mom, where are you? You come in and she's laying on the floor. My question to you is can you pick her up and drag her? You know, you're a bigger guy. You know what I'm saying? So I in your case, I'm going to say, yeah, you can.
Yeah.
But let's flip the script. Can she pick you up?
Right. No chance.
I've had clients that have had stroke. Their husbands had stroke. And she could pick up, she was able to pick up her husband. The reason I bring that story up is because there was a lady who wanted to get in shape, right? I want to work out. And so I'm teaching her how to do a deadlift, picking up a weight from the floor. Do I have to do that? That's like a man exercise. I don't want to look like a man. And I was like, it's not a man exercise. It's when you pick up a penny from the floor or drop a piece of paper, you got to pick it up. You pick up your three-year-old from the floor, pick him up to hold him on your arms. You're performing a deadlift. So reluctantly, this lady does this. A week later, true story, her grandmother has a stroke. She picks up her grandmother underneath the arms, drags her to the car, gets her to the hospital. The doctor tells her, had they waited for an ambulance, the stroke would have probably been irreversible. That lady comes in crying to me, telling me, oh my God, thank you for teaching me how to lift something properly off the floor. It's got nothing to do with your muscles. There's powerlifting competitions, great performance. That's a deadlift for that. But we're all performing deadlifts all day long. You pick up a bag of dog food from the grocery store. That's a deadlift. You pick up your kid. That's a deadlift. You're not learning. You're not becoming a man. You're being functional. So I get it. I think functional fitness is becoming like a cliche kind of word. It goes back to what you just said. I want to move freely. I want to feel good in my own skin. I don't want to be desperate for air. I don't want to breathing's a natural function of life. Why am I struggling to breathe? I can't breathe in deep. I can't go up a flight of stairs without being out of breath. So what is health and fitness? Is my body work for me or against me? This is another true story. Two incidents that I'm aware of, personally aware of. Let's say you go home, house fire, right? You live in a ranch.
Ranch house. Right?
Okay. Yeah. House fire. Most people die from smoke inhalation. Okay. You're a big, strong guy. But can you run around the block? I know guys that are bodybuilders and they don't run. And, you know, it's like, what good is that beach body if it doesn't work for you? So you come home, use the same story. Your mom is there, house is on fire. You're like, oh, shit, what's going on? Nobody called the police or ambulance or anything. You know, first instinct is my mom's in there. Let's say you can hear her screaming, threaten, right? Somebody help me. Panic mode. So adrenaline rush, boom. Can you save your mom?
I want to say yes.
We all do.
Yeah.
Your willpower will probably run you towards that house. That's mom. If it's your son, if it's your kid, it's a loved one. It doesn't matter. The willpower will run your ass into that house. Chances are you're going to die as well. Now, I'm not saying that a certain deadlift, you could deadlift 500 pounds. That means I'm going to save my mom. You could be the fittest person and still go in that house and die. What I'm trying to do with clients, I just want to give you a better chance. Better chance. Because at least you could say I did everything I could. Now, here's what's scary. And I take clients through a consult in the workout. I take them through an assessment workout. And I tell them, remember this question. Can you save your mom? Can you save your father, your husband, your son in a house fire? I bring it up when we do the workout, right? So let's just say that you run into that house. You got a low crawl to stay out of the smoke. That's one obstacle, right? But now you get in there, you find where she's at, but now a wall or a table or something's pinching her leg and she can't move. Can you lift it off of her and get her out? So now you're not thinking, see here, we're talking about life and death situations, running away from a dog, picking up somebody who had a stroke. And wait a minute, I thought I was joining a health and fitness. I thought I was going to come in here and look better. You are. But first, I got to help you move better. I have to have you perform. You're a human first. Before you are a six pack, you're a human first before you're dress size. Can that body work for you or against you?
You just listened to a short preview episode of the Life Power Journeys podcast with Coach Lewis. Stay tuned very soon for full episodes of this podcast. Oh, yeah.